offloaded there.
I wouldn't expect this one to be the hard one. I would expect the one to the stone to be the hard one.
Yeah.
But kind of meander yourself back towards this, that corner over here, just to kind of encourage her to go back in that area again.
I know it's the cat snap over here.
She picked up some odor, but then she went and pursued the other one. So I'm like, okay, at first I thought she was catching wind of the one she hasn't found yet. But then she went and found the other one, so then I thought, well, maybe that wasn't what she was smelling.
I don't know, guys.
Beautiful, beautiful side jump you did there into a perfect stack.
Yeah.
my general like recommendation and rule of thumb is don't necessarily take over the search for your dog and start asking them check places, but just start walking and guiding them and leading them around and hoping that you help them pick up some available odor. And just keep moving around the ring, because I think like we end up, I watched a video where I started helping Monroe, which I will never do again, but I was literally going around and asking her to check like the same 5 mounds of fluff over and over and over for like 2 whole minutes, and it's like, she told you no the first time, like why did you keep, you know? And then there was a whole another area of the course that I never even like took her to, and she never took herself to, because the judge was standing on the fence line, and he was a bigger guy, and the one rat she couldn't find was right, like, a foot from him along the fence, and she just wouldn't go over there. If I would have taken her over there, she would have gone over there, but by herself, she was like, yeah, I'm good, I can just avoid that area altogether.
Wow.
But I thought that she showed some interest under this one leaner,
yeah.
So I, like, hyper-obsessed, like, well, it's got to be over here somewhere, and she's just smelling it over here. No, it was way on the other side of the ring.
Jeez.
So it's like, I can't